this is a patellofemoral sling technique. So it's similar to the patellofemoral loop technique that you may have seen videos of. Only this time we're just using the 5 centimeter or 2 inch tape in separate pieces. So the idea with this is that if we find that a medially directed force is beneficial or pain relieving, perhaps when somebody squats down or steps up, if we come in and create a medially directed force and that alleviates their pain, then it makes sense to perhaps try and do that with the tape so that we can then build up their capacity, reduce that pain, reduce any pain inhibition and so on as we're going along. It's not necessarily appropriate for all of our patellofemoral joint pain subjects, and in some people, other techniques may be stronger contributing factors. It might be their hip adduction, internal rotation. It might be perhaps taping their foot to control their shank as well. So you need to look at those sort of things and determine the most appropriate. So this is going to put that medially directed force into the system. So we're going to start on the outside. The patellofemoral joint is probably one of the hardest things to get really good hold of the lever or the body part that we're trying to affect. And one of the fundamentals in getting a mechanical effect is that we have to get hold of the lever or the body part. Some people you'll find just through their anatomy, the contours of their soft tissue or the shape of their patella, is that you just can't get hold of it. If you can though, we can try and come in here. So what we're going to do is try to create a slingshot effect by anchoring on the outside and then pulling both the top and bottom in medially. So we end up with this medially directed force vector on the patella. So we tear about 2/3 of the way along, and we're going to fix that to this lateral edge of the patella. So just push your patella laterally to find where that lateral edge is. And then we want about half the tape on the patella and half lateral to it. Then come in and do your medial glide. Maintain that while we then come in and turn this one medially, and then a nice anchor point at the end without any tension. I'm going to swap our hands over and do the same at the top. So again, direct that medially, keep your tension on as you turn that corner and sweep around and come up and finish in onto those adductors. You can see it starts to box up all of that soft tissue. We can come in and maximize that soft tissue offload by coming through. Again, you may even want to bring in a rotation component if that was more pain relieving. And you can do that by sweeping around or by picking up this inferior pole as you come through to create a rotation moment at the joint as well. So here we'll just focus on that soft tissue offload. So we'll start on skin. We'll get better adhesion of the tape. Anchor, pull all that soft tissue together a little bit more, tension on, and then stick down. Ensure that the tape stays anterior to the axis of the knee joint. We don't want to start pulling into flexion. And if we stay anteriorly, what it means is when the knee bends that we actually are providing some resistance and we're creating a bit of a knee extension force moment. So we're doing some eccentric quadriceps work essentially to take some load off that whole patellofemoral quadriceps mechanism. If you want to lock over the top of everything and even perhaps get a little bit more medially directed force and perhaps a little bit of force closure to help stabilize and have that patella sort of maintained within the groove of the femur, we can come over the top. And for that, we're going to use the 3-inch tape. Just line that up with the top of the patella. Start once again on the skin laterally to get good adhesion. Apply that medially directed force once again. A little bit of tension on, sweep through, and then make sure there's absolutely no tension on this medial aspect of the knee, as it does break down fairly easily if you have the tape shearing on the skin there. If you start that too high, you'll find that when they bend up, the patella will pop out underneath it. So make sure you line that up with around about the top of the patella. What we can see now is when I'm pushing laterally, the patella here is contained within this slingshot band around the outside. And then when we bend, it all just tightens up a little bit more and just creates this, or encapsulates the patella and creates that slight medial force there. Go back and reassess their active movement, whether that was a step up or a squat, and just see if it doesn't change things, then perhaps it's not appropriate. Some of our chronic ones, we'll find that it's that unloading 24 hours a day for a couple of days that has the result. So providing they're not worse, it might be worth trying out. But most people, you'll find that if it's effective, it will be effective immediately, and you'll get significant reduction in pain, 50% or more. Generally, I like it to essentially abolish the pain almost immediately.